They constructed Dover's fortifications on an impressive scale from 1180 onwards. Both sides of the town are littered with forts and defensive positions. In our final episode, we continue exploring Fort Burgoyne that was built to protect Dover Castle. Andrew Morgan continues showing us around. Let's go, folks.
So in some places you had water standpipes, but you also had lamps, street lamps if you like.
Huh. Now it's just a nice trip hazard.
You can hear we're in Dover, can't you?
Yeah.
Police.
These exotic things are for hanging fire buckets on.
Alright.
Oh, wow.
You know, red metal buckets with fire written on in black. Here's your thing.
Just walk past them, you know, you wouldn't even.
No.
To hang a bucket. So this is an original washroom with these slate long wash basins in effect. You can see the piping where there would have been taps, equally the plug holes, and amongst the, in the refuse tip we found, I think it was 13 new plugs on chains. And then the water just runs down here. Equally you've got runaways in each place. More recent years, you can see from the writing on here, it's been used when the fort was used as a vehicle store, batteries for use, i.e. it's where you top up batteries with distilled water and possibly charge them up.
Right.
But originally this is where troops would have kind of washed, done their ablutions, hooks up here to put their equipment on while they did that, balance a little mirror here, off you go.
Amazing. It's good condition, isn't it?
There's the water tank. For this washroom. So zinc water tank, and then some showers behind.
Showers?
Yeah. It's asbestos covered piping, so.
Oh. Something like that, asbestos.
It looks like a mop.
It looks like part of a belt or something, doesn't it?
Yeah, a strap.
Nice stuff.
What's the...
Yes, what is it?
Yeah.
Is that like a vent or something?
So, when I was, last time on the tour, when we showed around, it was a mystery. It's like a cat flap.
Yeah, big one.
Big cat flap.
So you've obviously got light coming in, but I would suggest that that's for some kind of electrical power.
Right.
Because that's been pushed through the original brickwork.
Yeah.
There's no, although there's a lintel for the window.
Yeah. It does look like it's added
it's
in
more
after.
Modern, I would suggest. But it doesn't replace anything older.
Who knows? Oh, yeah.
They've been repainted, but these are certainly of an age. They've got Donald Duck, Mickey Mouse.
Yeah, I saw them last time. It's crazy. I told you, mate.
Pictures,
do you? I have a photograph of a Victorian barrack room. So, this is daytime. As you can see, folding legs, trestle table. And benches, all the cleaning equipment, the different types and shapes of brooms, water buckets, etc. Some pretty foliage, ironically a bicycle wheel, it appears there. The type of lantern, and we have a similar shade hanging up in one of the other rooms here. And then his equipment, shelves and racks. And you can see the equipment hanging down,
Yeah. Exactly
as you saw. And then each man had a personal locker, like on board a ship, a wooden locker you keep under your bed. And at night time, trestle table and benches fold up out of the way, and the beds are folded out, and the biscuit mattress folded out, laid out, so that you sleep on that.
Hmm. That's amazing. I've never seen that picture before.
This is not taken here, because No. It's got windows in two aspects, so it's not here.
That's a good example, though.
Yes, it's a perfect example.
I didn't realise the bed's folded up like that.
Yeah. Mm.
It's a good idea.
Yeah, looks like a lounge.
It's to maximise space.
Yeah.
Amazing. What sort of date were these put in then, these Donald Duck things?
I'm sorry.
What date?
1930s.
1930s.
But most likely, yes. World War II vintage, I would have thought.
Yeah.
And then repainted more recently.
Still got all the rails.
Exactly, you've got little bits. And in another room, we've got the wall cover, etc. Yeah. So there's nothing you wouldn't bring in front. And you look at this original door, much more substantial. Okay, there's great big hinges.
This took a beating.
Yes.
Bayonet. Let me out. Christ, I need one of them on front door.
Can I take
your
time? Yeah. So that's the other shower block. And this goes along to the end into a wedge-shaped storeroom between the barrack rooms. What I'm going to do is I'm going to shut this door, we just keep going along, do look in each room, and I'll catch you up down the end.
Yeah, yeah.
And after the way the glass is also...
Yeah, the light comes in naturally, it's amazing.
Yeah. Wow, this door. You've got to come and look back on that.
Wow.
What's been going on here? Testing bayonets or something.
Oh, Christ.
Yeah,
it's proper been done.
Interesting. It must be the original paint though. There doesn't seem to be any other colours underneath.
No smoking again.
No smoking.
Oh, Belfast sink. Broken. They're always broken there, aren't they?
Yeah. Always. What's the date on it, Chris?
Sunk on that one.
Something right. AC Courtyard, WC Courtyard.
Oh. Oh, the screen's flipped. Damn it. Should be able to get it.
Point is, one of the rooms was a medical centre.
Right.
And in a way, it would make sense to have, you know, sluice area, wash basins, etc.
Yeah.
We do have some amazing fungi and stuff growing through because of the constant damp.
Yeah, I've seen all those strange covers. What was this in here?
If you look at the fittings here as well, for extra light, presumably.
Oh, yeah.
You can see one of these wedge-shaped storerooms, which helps make it the curve of the arch.
Oh, yeah.
You go in, it's all solid. And you can see where the racking was originally.
Yes.
And if you go out onto the parade ground, you can see the ventilation bricks, and you can make out where you are. But of course, this is helping make the curve.
Yeah.
And if you look at this vaulting, okay, so we've come out of a barrack room.
Right.
We know, parallel to the barrack room, there's a storage area. And we know, in the Victorian period, there was no small arm storage anywhere, there was no armoury building. So the way, the safety thing was to keep the ammunition separate. And here is one of the ammunition storage rooms. So you have a bolted door and you have two sections. So again, an inner door, which you probably would have had a serving area here, but obviously you can secure that and then hand out or serve the ammunition through this hatch here.
Right.
So the weapons were with the people, but the ammunition is stored separately.
Strange ceiling in this one.
Oh, wow, yeah. And the brick one.
Yeah.
And you can see an outline of where the racking would have been here. Equally, ventilation bricks there, chimneys above, and where access had been made in the past, that's been blocked up again.
Amazing. Oh, you see the link for that, wow. Yeah, is that another point for fire extinguisher?
A good one?
Fire extinguisher point.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The red markings.
Absolutely. That's why when you have the no smoking signs, quite often there's a red outline. Do you know that would be an extinguisher and possibly a water bucket?
Right.
this archway, as per the left hand archway, these lead out to the circular way, and you have the rather inferior but still effective iron gates, grills, etc., which are much simpler, less expensive than the ornamental ones at the bottom with the ramps down into the caponiers.
Right.
In this area, this is where the original Victorian cookhouse would have been, down below. And although this is of a later period, when this brickwork was like this, they used to have little porches on the front.
Right.
So it's not quite sure of the age, but if it's not period, then it's, you know, an ongoing facsimile.
Yeah.
So we saw on the other flank archway, you had a gate, an iron gate in the middle, and an iron gate on the inside. So we have a cookhouse, and we have another room, just slightly right of where you're standing, which had a big copper, a big stew boiling receptacle in the corner.
Right.
So there's meat storage, preparation, reduction of carcasses into joints of meat to make stew, etc., as required.
Okay, this was
the officer's mess originally.
Right.
Slight differences you'll see in here. Some of the officers' mess buildings were fully wood panelled. This appears not to have been, although there were partitions in it. It has a different, starting at the ceiling and looking down, you can see the chimney is a much larger circular arrangement rather than the plain tubes of the barrack rooms. The reason for that is there would probably be a large round light fitting, completely different, rather than the simple trick ones. Equally, you have a built-in substantial mantelpiece and a more traditional domestic fireplace. You can see that originally at some time there would have been a partition. You can see marks here, both on the floor and on the ceiling here. And we have two rooms at the back. Originally, that was access to a toilet. This one, which is a plain room, storage room into the shop, was the officer's wine and beer store.
Right. Wine and beer store, that sounds like fun.
Beer?
But if you look at the quality of the doors and the fact that they're much more ornamental, as are the door surrounds.
Crazy, is
it? It's better quality door than my front door.
If you look at it from this side, if I just...
Oh, it's wedged.
It's a wedge, one more. But the point is, you can see that the arch is quite ornamental over the top to fit in with the panel door. And then into the corridor, you have a secure cable. But you have a door that can be barricaded, locked, etc. And anyone coming in to the archway, just it's a door, no more different than any other. So in theory, you could shut the outer one, blockade it full of bricks or whatever you want, and then close the inner one as well. You've got that massive thing. And in the officer's mess side, you have some more original, more domestic type fittings.
Yeah. Even the lock.
Mm.
That's been bricked up behind this one.
Yeah.
So that was the toilet. It's been blocked up at some time in the past, and there's a more modern toilet being put in with access from the corridor as well.
Right.
May originally have access from the corridor, but it's certainly on the original plans as having been direct access from here.
Yeah.
Which would explain the partition here is somewhat more discreet here.
Yeah.
when you go in, because we've got lots of unsafe floor areas, this room goes into an upper food, more serving area, but equally we've got a bathroom opposite. I wouldn't go in there necessarily. And there is one unique feature we can have a look at if we go downstairs very quickly, which ties in. Equally, if you look at the original writing on here, see it says 900 feet, four men. Wow. Is it feet or is it another longer way? Before we go very quickly down there, so you've got access to the food area here, and unusually you don't have access, but you have an area with hinge doors with a lintel. Okay, when we go downstairs, we'll see the bottom of it, and then you'll understand what would be behind here. Bear in mind that the officer's mess doorway is there, or if you want a discreet area, that's
right.
So we're just going to go along to the gate, chuck the left, to keep the light on. So this is the more modern toilet facilities, but they've been created by blocking up the officer's mess access and making this the usual general access. There is light, but there is light.
Rightio.
Okay, so we're going down to below ground level. So look at the rather ornamental top of the handrail here, the stairs. Equally, if you come through and we shut this a bit, you can see how much of the original timber and glass work is still standing here.
Yeah.
So if you go down the steps, just mind the edge, but it should be fine. Handrails only attached by cable ties in places.
That's lovely.
If you look at the rail supporting the handrail here, they're just straightforward square bars. But when we get down, I'll show you something different.
Is that for gas light?
Yeah.
Crazy, isn't it?
A window up there as well.
Equally, yes. That goes in the food room bathroom. Right. Into a much more ornamental, flowered, sort of more Egyptian style post there. Which ties in with the gate we saw in the central cabin here, this one. You can see it's got a spearhead only at the hinge end, but not all the way along.
It's got spikes on this one.
Yeah, I was going to say.
So although they've been cut off, they're just plain square bars set at an angle. So this is the right flank cabin here, exactly the same as the centre one, but single-sided only.
Yeah.
And you have the wooden double doorway in the back of that.
Crazy. I'm just going to shine it up and get the length.
How's that coming out?
Not bad.
Okay, so we've got storage rooms here and there with ventilation.
Ceiling.
Yeah. There's a ventilator. Sometimes you can see the sunlight coming into there. And that shows you what we were standing on above.
Yes.
Yeah, that's...
Which is why the other part we don't go in at all, and this part is less than perfect. So even in the officer's mess, you tend to tell people not to hang around, but to spread out.
Spread out.
It's a bit...
Yeah, don't all stand in the same place.
It's a bit... We're going to go back here. So you can see this is the original floorway, and then it goes down the ramp into the flag, right flag caponier. But this went through these gates and then up the ramp to parade ground level. Storerooms with some of the racking still in place.
And a new ceiling.
Yeah. That was a bit.
I think that would feel a bit better to walk on.
Yeah.
What light like fit? Okay.
Yeah.
Thickness of that door.
That's mad, isn't it?
Beam.
Be able to shoot through that.
Light fitting, base. That's the same as gas lamp, domestic fitting. And a wooden block on the wall like that. So we've got some storerooms here. We've got a water tank, another zinc water tank. We have storerooms. As you can see, it's slate shelves. Oh yeah, slate because it's easy to wash down. Very clean, and it's cool.
So slates in
the room.
Freezing.
Sink water tank with piping that goes into this room, which will go in from the other end of the mount.
Right.
Shall we go?
Yep.
God, that is heavy.
Somewhat more damaged, but again, slate shelving for food storage, and you notice the big hooks hanging down here. There was no butchery as such, but meat carcasses would come into the fort and then be butchered, i.e. cut into smaller joints. So they'd be hung up here, cut into pieces.
Wow. It's a humming sound.
So a lot missing, but still the same as you saw in the other room.
Yeah.
Sash windows. Get as much ventilation as possible. You can see down this.
It's really wet there, isn't it?
Right, mind the open drains and things here. Don't trip them out. Okay, so originally the ramp would have gone straight up here, up to parade ground level.
Yep.
Now it makes sense that this is the food storage and preparation area. Like this little dead end room here, there'd be someone with a desk there counting into a ledger all the food stuff coming into the fort, so you know at any one time what we should have in stock, whether it being short measured or whatever.
Yeah.
Okay, ensuring the quality is good. And explained with the fear of artillery fire, plunging fire coming in, but these all end up blocked up.
Just saying that there's still a hinge there, no door, but the hinge is still there.
Oh,
yep. That's all set. The hinge.
Yeah.
We go left here. You can feel the draft, even though
you can,
we're below
yes.
ground level. However, open water soakaways, with the water level so high. Not good. If we come into this area, remember I said we had a room with a copper in it, which is like a great big copper bowl that you would brew up stew, etc. That's in the corner there, the remains. Sadly, the copper's not, but the brickwork, it would have been in it here.
It's like raining
in here.
Wow, it's crazy, isn't it?
You can see where there would have been a fire underneath it, as you can see the chimney.
Yeah.
And you can see the amount of damp.
Yeah, it's horrible.
Slabs just across the corridor here. So here, this was the original cookhouse. So we have a big copper water boiler up here. There would have been another one on this base here. And you can see pipe work for various water heaters down here. Now, we've got a section here which is brick, while the rest is not. The reason for that, there would have been a big iron cooking range here, because we are short distance across the corridor, just alongside, from the officers' mess. So you're not mass producing food, you're also being able to produce food of decent quality when you have guests coming or VIPs visiting the fort. So you have an oven and you have a cooking range for frying, etc. Of course that's been taken and scrapped, but you can see where it was. It's a standard feature in a type of fort of this type of the period. That would be there on the brickwork. The interesting bit is this corner. It's not a window, but it had a sash window arrangement. And this is actually the roof of a dumb waiter.
Oh, yeah.
So you'd have a handle or wheel on here. When you prepared your dishes to go up to the officer's mess, you put it in the dumb waiter, and there's the winch reel there. Now this being the roof, the level is a couple of feet further down. You'd winch that up to the level above. Whereas instead of being in food preparation clothing, you'd have smartly dressed, white-dressed waiters to take in into the officer's mess. So you have that separation between food preparation and food service. So you have that instant access to take it up to this side. And in the corridor, I showed you where there were hinges with no good reason. That's the shaft going, that's the top end of the shaft here.
All right.
This is the hook from the top of the shaft, which had a cable onto here. And you can see these are the sides at the top of the dumbwaiter itself. So the floor, that's one level, and there'll be another level below it. In fact, you can see the inside of that,
it's a hatch.
Those double hatches. Exactly. Yeah. I just visualised this as one of these cooking programmes in here. Done out as period, everything all polished up, absolutely stunning.
Yeah.
Try and get as much ventilation as possible. Yes. Ventilation above the doors, everywhere.
Don't jump the door. Watch the old stair.
The These rooms are very similar. Originally they would have been for sergeant cooks, that kind of personnel.
Right.
Army's full bolt on one, don't they? Go and have a look around. Some of them have been more recent storage area. Little corridor behind some of them. Equally at the end, above, you can see the concrete additions to the magazines under the ramp.
Oh, yeah. That's spongy.
We have that little spot that's not great. The point is, if you look at originally the access to these rooms, there was no railing whatsoever. Okay? And those big slabs, when they're worn away, as they were by foot, you get puddles in them.
You slip off it. Yeah.
You know? Which is why you didn't want soldiery returning drunk from the town.
No.
Can do, mate.
You want for every day of the year in Snargate Street alone. You know, you don't want people in
the old light.
Wow.
Shades of mould.
Yes. We have some fantastic white mould all over the whole one. Now, on these far extensions at each end of the curved casements, there's a staircase going up to the upper level, to ground level, if you like. But you can see from the underneath the floor above. But you can see the ornamental post at the bottom of the handrails and this kind of thing, even though the wood of the handrail is missing in that case. And sash windows internally, as well as externally.
There's more light.
Well, more ventilation at the point. It would have been better in the food preparation area because you've almost got fires going on most of the day. But still cold and damp and horrid. And although it's locked off the periods and then unlocked and locked up again, you know, a small semblance of corridor at the back of these rooms as well.
Yeah.
Just a thick wall, this.
Absolutely. Built to last a siege.
Yeah.
You seen the film with Daniel Day-Lewis, Last of the Mohicans? French-Canadian war, you know, pre-1800. And they're besieging a wooden stockade fortress. The French are with mortars.
Right.
It's a perfect illustration of the kind of weapon that's still being used in the Victorian period, where you're firing a massive, almost cartoon spy bomb with a fizzing fuse at the top to, you know, to blow this kind of thing.
Yeah.
That's been quite strong.
Yeah.
What we found?
Nothing.
So it helps when we get tools, we can open up the rooms a bit, just get some air through.
Yeah.
But by the nature, by the construction of it, as you can see, all the leaf mould blocks the drains up. We have cleared them all. It's a never-ending task. And anyway, they were never very efficient when they were built.
No.
I still can't believe they didn't have railings.
No.
Mind the
gutter.
You've seen the centre cap in here. So this is just half of that, effectively, with no sally port. So
yes.
There's nothing you've not seen already.
It's the same as the other one, the other end, isn't it, as well?
Yeah.
Yeah. So. Nice deal.
Okay.
Yeah. Carefully. That's not the floor, that's a new floor, isn't it? Chris.
Pardon?
It's a new floor, that one, isn't it?
Yeah.
It would.
If you come back, it's wet, there's all these puddles just here, and they're slippery as anything, really dangerous. You can see why they put railings and things.
Yeah. Yeah, definitely. That's pretty much it then, really, isn't it?
Pretty much. There's one more little bit I can show you, but I suggest we see if everybody else has gone home and they've locked us in.
Right.
Because it must be other three.
Half
Might as well bury me now, I'm so dead. This has changed dramatically. Originally there was a flanking battery that fired down the ditch towards the eastern outwork. The access is the ditch under the Deal Road nowadays, but that's all blocked off. So originally there was a two-gun battery with those two 18-pounders firing along that ditch. Bigger guns, not carronades, because the range would be a bit longer. But this has always been, in recent years, the sort of junkyard. So there's all kinds of rubbish in there. Some of it's interesting. We found batteries for Second World War survival dinghies. We found someone practicing making dog tags, but the numbers don't match any known casualties or anything like that. They don't even match regimental numbers. All kinds of scrap cars, bits of a drawbridge, all kinds.
So there's a few bits there then?
Yeah.
All right. Should we have a look?
But the original expense magazines, the underground gunpowder magazines for the muzzle-loading cannon are still there. And then through that archway you can just see in the distance that goes out at a slight angle onto that circular way, the Chemin de Ronde, but onto that corner. So slightly offset, you've got that trench going out under the road to Deal. And then this part, you've got the 1940s defences, the pillbox and the spigot mortar position alongside it.
Do a quick look?
Yep.
And this, what's your feet?
Try and avoid this bit, it's all ash. Been burning.
Oh yeah, watch that. It's ash.
Remains of an old washing machine, barbed wire,
Chris.
Telephone cable, scrap iron, and there's the remains of an old part of a floor pan of a 1930s car. It's part of a handbrake. Junk. So it's pretty muddy here, mine's stuck there, but to the right is the ventilation corridor and lighting corridor, and straight ahead is the main magazine for the little batteries, the driving some magazines.
Can you turn the light on?
Yeah. Where should I go in that one? Oh, I can't go in that one.
Cool. Hey, it's really cool.
Thank you. I'll tell you, if you touch the walls, you'll be covered in white.
Right.
Oh, wow.
Do you want me to pass you the camera? I'll get over there.
White mode. Right.
Glad that wasn't the camera.
That was just the, that's it.
It's a lot for the light, it's the lighting passage, that.
Yeah. Like the ones at the Sheerness one.
Yeah. Bucket.
Old classic. Jump over. Stick of mortar.
Stuff like that. And you can see the corrugated iron for the mounting.
Yeah, oh yeah.
The trench around it. It's unusual. Mostly they're circular, and there's a sort of framework that you cast into, but a square one is less common. So you can go in. This pillbox is all being cleared out.
Right. That tree in front of it.
So it's unusual that it's got a brick entranceway.
Yeah.
That tree must have been there before the pillbox.
Yeah.
Cool.
It's alright, isn't it?
It's a good condition, isn't it?
Yeah. A real golden gem.
How about a view of the tree?
Got nice wide shelves just inside the firing points here, so if you have a machine gun, you can actually sort the tripod out to rest on there.
Yeah.
Equally, if you need to get more wider field of fire, you get a Bren gun in there and have the magazines to hand to one side on that shelf.
Yeah.
Equally, you can have a couple of grenades to hand and just drop them out if anyone gets really close. So this centrepiece like this, various things where things would have been mounted, a little shelf, possibly might have been connected by a field telephone, but the idea is any rounds coming in hit that and just effectively just fall to the ground, hopefully.
Yeah.
Rather than spinning around as they might inside a tank.
Yeah. Has it thought about?
Yep. Well, and it gives you extra support for the roof, so
yes.
So the edge of the ditch is literally just here, so be careful. Now, you can see here, although it's been, the levels have been very much reduced, the flanking battery, as it's called, the side along that ditch, which goes out towards the water coast, along the ditch out to the artwork. You can see that there would have been two firing points here, but it's all been completely dismembered just to put more 1940 defences.
Quick look over there.
Sorry, mate.
There's a nasty little slope through that archway. Take great care there.
Right.
On the right hand side, there's a little dispense magazine or a little room for gunner's tools, sponges, ramrods, etc.
Here's a bit wet.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
That's the grill that goes above the main door.
Yeah.
Oh, cool.
And then here we are. And
wow.
Coming out onto the circular way again.
Crazy, isn't it? Looks and crannies.
Put this up there. Quite useful having that tree there.
Yeah.
God, that's deeper than it looks. Isn't it?
Just further down that ditch. Here is the open ground. It's part of the airfield originally. This is now the recreation area that continues directly from the side of the road. Up to the Duke of York's.
Yep.
Further along here, that's been the ditch has been blocked off, and there's been a foot access with a protected entry gate.
Right.
You know, a rotating gate. It's used in recent years.